I made a video about the history of JavaScript, or rather the history of JavaScript security, and I had planned to continue telling the story about what happened after 1996. But after doing more research, I actually found out a lot more about these super early first JavaScript hacks. And that was so fascinating to me that I felt like I have to share it with you. So here, let me present to you the three JavaScript security legends of 1996, Scott Weston, John Tennyson, and John Robert Loverso. Keep watching if you want to know what makes them legends. Quick recap. In the previous video, I told you about Netscape 2.0 from early 1996, which introduced JavaScript. And I showed you a vulnerability. Basically, we could create a website that loads two different sites in an iframe, and the JavaScript running on the one website could read out the content and cookies of the other website. Or an alternative exploit could also be that instead of another website, you load a local folder in the browser and steal the list of files from there. And yes, as many correctly pointed out, there is a small nuance differences between the term site and domain, but for the purpose of exploring these old vulnerabilities, I think it doesn't matter. I'm also sure the difference didn't exist yet in 1996. Anyway, the issue was fixed in Netscape 2.02, which basically prevented one domain using JavaScript to access the content of another domain or site or whatever they called it. And that's very cool, but the thing is, I kind of just imagined what the first vulnerabilities looked like by reading between the lines and applying my experience in browser client security. But after many more hours reading mailing lists, I found something crazy. It all started with this email from 1997 on the Backtrack mailing list. John Robert Loverso, one of the three legends, wrote an email criticizing somebody about an inaccurate JavaScript vulnerability description, and here he says this: "As history, I found a bug with JavaScript and file upload about 16 months ago in Netscape 2.01. Just a few days after that release. I did not release details of that bug until 2.0.2 was released." This exactly falls into the early timeline. JavaScript was invented and introduced in Netscape 2.0, and 2.0.2 had the famous fix. So he was one of the people reporting those very early JavaScript attack ideas to Netscape, and apparently it was related to JavaScript and file uploads. Going to his website, thanks to the web archive, we can find here a list of JavaScript issues he discovered, and check this out. The bug in Netscape 2.0 Beta 3 that allowed JavaScript to directory browse lives on in the 2.0 release even after Netscape told us it was fixed. This link also still works, so this is one of the actual first JavaScript exploits ever. So, what does it do? With 2.0, when you click on list directory, a window will pop up with the directory contents, which will be read and displayed below in the result box. Clicking submit to send the result box off to remote host, meaning the results have been stolen. So let's have a look at the JavaScript source of this page. First, it references a few forms and elements. That part is not important, it's just to display information later. More importantly is the doDir function, which grabs a user's directory. So here it first gets the folder name of the list or steal directory input element, creates the file URI, and assigns it to the action to the doDirSteal form. So when the form is submitted, it will submit it to the directory URL. But before it submits it, it opens another window. After that window is open, it will submit the form. And then comes doDir2, which goes through the document of this new window and extracts all links. Now, on first sight, this might look different to what I guessed the first exploit might have looked like, but actually, it's very similar. As you can see, first, the extraction stealing part. We simply access the document links and take them. Only difference is how we load the victim directory list. I loaded the folder in another frame, and here we load the files in another window. The code is super weird though, this doesn't work anymore in modern browsers. But this is setting here the form action URL and submits the form, but instead of this form submitting to the main window where the code runs, it will submit it to the new opened window. To be honest, this sounds like a bug, at least today, but back then it seemed like a neat trick to submit a form into a new window instead of submitting it on the same page. Anyway, window is loaded, links extracted and placed into this text box, which could then be sent to another server to steal it. So this was actually one of the first JavaScript attacks, and that's why John Robert Loverso is one of the three legends. But there's more here. Chronology, original report by Tennyson describing these bugs in 2.0 beta 3. So here is the second legend we are going to meet, John Tennyson. While the link here was unfortunately not archived by the Web Archive, at least now I had a name to research more, which led me to this amazing article by Keith Dawson in the Tasty Bits from the Technology Front newsletter or magazine. Keith was documenting some of these very early JavaScript security events, so let's read a paragraph here. JavaScript, which started out life as LifeScript, displayed security flaws as early as beta 2. Scott Weston was among the first to be awarded Netscape's $1,000 bug bounty for his demonstration of a way to capture the clickstream of the browser user. The bug was fixed in beta 3. Whoa. Was Netscape the first company offering a bug bounty program around 1996? Huh. This seems like it even goes back to 1995, as seen in this news article. The company has also announced a bugs bounty program offering $1,000 to the first person who can identify a major security bug in the new beta version of its Netscape browser software. Damn, I thought bug bounty is a super modern term, but it is not. Wow. Anyway, we got sidetracked. Back to the article. So Scott Watson is the third legend we are going to meet. And there's actually another TBTF article about this finding here. As you can see, this even related to the first release where JavaScript was still called LifeScript. So this might really be the very, very first public JavaScript or LifeScript exploit, which could make Scott Watson the true grandfather of JavaScript security. Scott Weston discovered a gaping security hole in Netscape's second beta that can result in a chilling loss of privacy. And they have fixed it already. I hope they pay him the $1,000 under their bugs bounty program. The problem is in LifeScripts. So let's have a look at this privacy bug. Here Scott says the LifeScript that I wrote extracts all the history of the current Netscape window. Unfortunately, he didn't attach example code and other links I found were dead, but looking at the JavaScript manual of like 1997, we know there is a history list, and maybe his exploit was simply taking the links of that list and sending it to another server. Unfortunately, Netscape has fixed this bug in 2.0 beta 3, and the Netscape version I have is that beta 3. So I think that's why I couldn't read the history here. If anybody has a beta release from before beta 3 where JavaScript was still LifeScript, please send it over to me. Anyway, let's read another paragraph of TBTF. In early January, a cluster of bugs with similar effect was reported by John Tennyson against beta 4. He was awarded a $1,000 bounty. Netscape claimed to have worked around these problems in beta 5 and 6. They said that the real fix would come in version 2.1. On February 13, Loverso notified Netscape that one of these bugs, the directory browser, still exists in the released Navigator 2.0. So, as you can see, these three people all reported serious JavaScript security bugs in the early months of 1996. And that's why I call them the legends of JavaScript security. Scott Weston, John Tennyson, and John Robert Loverso. Now, to put this all a bit more into context again, what does this all mean? You have to keep in mind, it's early 1996. JavaScript was just invented. Netscape was running full force into the future, trying to implement new features to make a rich web experience. And at the time, Java applets already existed for dynamic client applications, but at the time there were constantly serious Java issues in browsers allowing for drive-by downloads, you know, serious browser exploits. So Netscape came along and claimed or hoped that JavaScript is a lot more secure than Java. But I guess this claim motivated these people to look into it, uncovering lots of issues, leading to articles like this one. JavaScript can make no claim to being provably secure, As Loverso points out, since Java was designed to be secure in the network environment, its design and implementation has been examined by hundreds, perhaps thousands of knowledgeable and critical people. Netscape's JavaScript is a separate implementation of an interpreted, not pre-compiled language, syntactically similar to Java. It derives no security from the similar name. And this is important. Maybe this is the reason why Netscape wanted to have Java in the name, because Java was familiar and carried some trust, at least in the regular computer user world. But unlike to Java, there is no specification for JavaScript available for public scrutiny. In contrast, Java is specced with details of the language, the bytecode, and the virtual machine. Netscape's JavaScript specification is intimately tied to the single existing implementation of the language in the Navigator browser. The source code has not been examined by anyone outside of the company. Crazy times. Of course, nowadays JavaScript has a spec. It grew into a very mature language, and you probably have all heard about ECMAScript. That's basically the JavaScript language specification, and it was initially released in 1997. So that's 1 year after the events presented in this video. All right, now that we have explored the very first months of JavaScript enough, we can slowly move forward. And a little bit over half a year after JavaScript was added to Netscape, in August 1996, Internet Explorer from Microsoft would join the scene with their copy implementation of JavaScript called JScript. So let's see what happened next in the history of browser client-side security.